Welcome student, in our first lecture, that is the introduction of syllabus of BSc third year botany, paper number 2, plant diversity 4th. Student, in our first unit, the name of our first unit is paleobotany. It should be completed in 15 lectures and it having 4 sub points. The first sub point is lepidodendron, all forms of genera like in root genera, stem, bark, leaves, male, female fructification. Second subunit, Lichenopteris, all form like in root, stem, leaves, male and female fructifications. The third subunit is a Pentaxylon, all forms of genera. And fourth, that is contribution of Birbal Sahani, and a Birbal Sahani instead of Paleobotany, Lucknow. Basically, Lepidodendron is nothing but a fossil plant. It also known as a scale tree, which is in an extinct tree which has one of the most abundant trees in Carboniferous period. The common fossil is found into the Carboniferous period. Look these three photographs I included here. The first one, that is the leaves traces, then second one a scaly like structure that is nothing but a stem, and the white colored a cone like structure here that is nothing but the LS of Strobilus of Lepidodendron. We will discuss detail every leaf genera, stem genera and strobilus genera. I want to make one clear thing here that when we are studying the paleobotany, there are the a different method employed here to studying or to naming the plants, because a whole plant individual is not found in one place into the fossil evidence. So the root is found in one area, one country, the leaves is found in another country or some in another continent, the stem is found in another locations, then flower, then male cone, female cone are found various different places. So due to that, every plant individual having its own name. So that's why we are using term here, the root genera, stem genera, leaf genera, male and female fructification genera. So likewise, in our Lepidodendron, we will study here the leaf genera, then stem and strobilus, how the microsporophyll, megasporophyll and other characteristics will be discussed in this subunit. There is another subunit I told you, that Lichenopteris. In Lichenopteris we have to study here the systematic position like order, family, genus we have to study. Then here is written also Pteridospermal is the order, then family Lichenopterisae, then genus Lichenopteris. A Lichenopteris is an late Carboniferous seed form stem with a distinct outer cortex of a sclerid forming a pattern in a cross section like Roman numerals on the rock face, often called as the sphagnum cortex. Some Lichenopteris were parasites by water molds, parasite. So look at the photographs, fern like habit completely we are looking here, then we doesn't have any live material of it, for that we have to take the permanent slides or some photographs we have on the with the help of that photographs, with the help of that slides, permanent slide, we will study the stem sections and its pith, then leaf traces, then cortex, periderm, then sclerotic nest and secondary wood we will discuss in these stem genera. There is again another genera in our Lichenopteris, that is a male reproductive organ genera is there, then leaf genera is also is there. So look at the one Crossathica species, that is a male reproductive structure genera, that is Lichenopteris oldamia, commonly called it as. Look, the microsporangia are arranged on the basal side, lower side of the one leaves like structure. Then second image is also is there, the leafy image is there. Look at the leaf arrangement. So this is one another evidence, so that's why it is called as the leaf genera. Okay, then come to the next point, that is the third, that is the Pentoxylon, which is belongs to Pentoxyleles. Basically these Pentoxyleles and Pentoxylon is discovered by Birbal Sahani in 1948 from our Bihar districts of our India. In Pentoxyleles also we will discuss about the its systematic position of Pentoxyleles, discovery of Pentoxyleles in our India, then detailed distinguishing features of Pentoxyleles. There again stem genera in Pentoxyleles also, which is honored after the name of Birbal Sahani, that is Pentoxylon Sahani. Then leaf genera, Nipponiophyllum, and some seed bearing organs of Phytoxyleles, and the affinity means similarities between other gymnospermic plants and the Pentoxyleles, and conclusion on to the Pentoxyleles. Look at the different photographs I shown here, that the Sahania, genus Sahania is there, a detailed microsporophyll structure is there, then in the central there is the Sahania nipponensis reproductive structure as the male flower, and finally into the right side there is the one female cone showing a seed bearing organs, then leaves. So these are the different genera forms of our Pentoxylon genus, and we will discuss about the structures. Then in this unit there is a last subunit, that is the contribution of Professor Birbal Sahani. The Professor Birbal Sahani is the one of the first paleobotanist from our India who started to discover the fossil plants. Before the Birbal Sahani there is a nobody's worked on these particular topics. So Dr. Birbal Sahani, who is the pioneer study man in our field of paleobotany. What is meant by paleobotany? That is the study of fossils, as you know that. He born in 14 November in 1891, and his death day is the 10th April 1949. The Birbal Sahani is basically interested in two or three disciplines like paleobotany, then geology. He had interested. Then Professor Birbal Sahani is developed, and he has founded one of the good paleobotanical institutes in our India, because his dream, nobody is working from our India, and he has completed his all postdoctorate then research in different countries, and he has one dream, the one institute should be in our India. That's why the Professor Birbal Sahani is founded one institute in our India. It is known as the Birbal Sahani Institute of Paleobotany, Lucknow. Especially the Birbal Sahani having a contribution to discovery of a different fossil plants, like as earlier slide, last slide I shown you these Pentoxyleles also discovered by Birbal Sahani in Bihar. There are various number of genera, various number of species is described by Birbal Sahani from Rajmahal Hills of Bihar. He is developed and started the Indian science education, and served as the president of a National Academy of Science India, and also a honorary president of International Botanical Congress. Apart from these some points, he has a different research paper he has published. So that detailed study we will take in this contribution of Birbal Sahani. In the unit second, you look here the angiosperm. The angiosperms are nothing but a plant which are showing a ovules enclosed within the ovary and basically a flowering plants. We call it as a flowering plants. In that second unit, there is a small subunit, morphology of the flower, all parts of the flower. So look at here, I shown here one small slide to you, that is one flower for you. There is a different small structures we have, like a pedicel, then sterile lemma, lodicules, palea, ovary, style, carpel, stigma, filament, stamen, anther and lemma. This is basically one monocotyledon flower. Actually everybody is trying to give a one Malvaceae family member, that is Hibiscus rosa chinensis. Every time we are from 11 to 12 we have studied the for morphology we are using a common example, Hibiscus rosa chinensis. But in our India, in our Maharashtra, we have the lot of number of grasses, and everybody should know about the grasses morphology, a flowers of a grasses. So that's why I included here one slide of grass. But this is also the same flower, because it is one of the advanced angiosperm. Basically in flower different organs we have, like essential organs, non-essential organs, like calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium, fruits, and every calyx and its different types, its modification. Then corolla, different type of the corolla and modifications in corolla. Then androecium, the arrangement of androecium and types of androecium. Then gynoecium, also we have to study in this small subunit, morphology of the flower with the all parts. The second point of this second unit is a Bentham-Hooker system of classification. We know that in the second year also we have taken a look on the Bentham-Hooker system. The Bentham-Hooker system is the one of the most accepted plant classification system for the angiospermic plants, especially in our continent. The taxonomic system of Bentham-Hooker, he has published for only seed plants, and which is published in a genera plantarum, which is published in 1862 to 1863 in a 3 volumes. The George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker was a British botanist and affiliated to Royal Botanical Garden, Kew, in England. As we know that the Kew Royal Botanical Garden is the one of the famous botanical garden, where the number of herbarium sheets are placed in one place, and in that institutes they are affiliated. So due to that, they have a good knowledge about the all plants of the world, because it is the one of the biggest herbarium, that is the Kew Herbarium. And the genera plantarum in which they both have published their system of classification, they have estimated about 97,205 species with 202 families and 7,569 genera. And he has given a detailed long classification system with its particular reasons behind it. So by using the order, family reasons, or some features of that particular family order, we can directly identify a broad group. Apart from his work, it having a different merits and demerits also. We know that every work whatever had done in the past in the field of botany, having its merit and having its demerit also. So that demerits and merits we will discuss in this subunit. Then come to the next point, that our small point, a Bentham-Hooker system of a classification of a flowering plants and family with respect to the economic value as well as the medicinal importance of every family. In our syllabus, there is a first family Combretaceae. In that, we have to study the Quiscalis indica, commonly called as the Malti. Then, Umbelliferae plant. Umbelliferae plant is nothing but a family of our Kothambir, we commonly called as a Kothambir. The name of that Kothambir is a Coriandrum sativa. Then Cucurbitaceae, Cucumis is there, Lupa is there, and all the Pepo group is belongs to Cucurbitaceae family. Then next one, that is the family Rubiaceae. In Rubiaceae, there is a good common example, that is Musanda, Citrifolia, and different others also we have in a Rubiaceae family, like Oldenlandia is there. Then come to the next family, that is the Solanaceae family. It is nothing but the brinjal family. Here we have to study the Dhatura, then Solanum. So other genera also we have. Then come to these all above families, like Combretaceae, Umbelliferae, Cucurbitaceae, Rubiaceae and Solanaceae. These are basically the dicot families. And in our syllabus, Commelinaceae and Graminaceae is the monocotyledon family. The Commelinaceae family is also represented in our Sindhudurg also, around our college also. So it is very easy to collect that Commelinaceae member, like Commelina belgamensis is the one good of the example. Then you can collect Murdania also, which is also flowering in July to November also. Then come to the last family, that is a Graminaceae. That is, now it is also called as the Poaceae family, and in that Poaceae family we have to study here the Oryza sativa, which is commonly cultivated in our Sindhudurg. Then come to the last unit, that is the anatomy. We know that the anatomy is nothing but a study of internal organs and a cellular structure, basically internal cellular structures. In that, what we have to study here, the anomalous secondary growth. What is mean by anomalous secondary growth, and what is mean by normal growth? When plant showing abnormal, plant showing abnormal characteristics internally, so that abnormal character studied under the bisectioning method. So that is called as the anomalous secondary growth into the different organs. It may be a stem, it may be a root. So in our syllabus, the anomalous secondary growth of Begonia, then Salvadora, Acheranthus aspera, then Dracaena, and in storage root like beet plant and a radish. So how these anatomically differ from the normal plant, that we have to discuss into the subunit. Then root stem transition. This is one of the very wonderful small subunit. We know that the every plant is having a root system, our angiosperm plant having a root system and shoot also. But the intermediate point where the root is finished and stem is started, so that point and their internal anatomical structure we are going to discuss in this small subunit. And types of stomata. A breathing organ of a plant, that is called as the stoma, you can call it also, and stomata also. There are a various type of the stomata we have. We know that the first one, that is the anomocytic. Then it is the one of the primitive stomata, which is found into the primitive plants. Which are primitive plants? In according with the Bentham-Hooker classification system, the Ranelagh's order is there. First order of our Bentham-Hooker classification system is the Ranelagh order, Ranelagh's. In that Ranelagh order, there are the number of family like Ranunculaceae, Magnoliaceae. These family plants are showing anomocytic type of the stomata. In anomocytic type of the stomata, we cannot differentiate the epidermal cells and subacidal cells. We cannot differentiate the epidermal cells and subacidal cells. Then the next, anisocytic. Anisocytic means uniso. Iso means similar, uniso means dissimilar. There are the three gardasil in this tomato which are completely dissimilar. So that's why such type of this tomato is the anisocytic. Then dicytic and parasitic, these are two type of this tomato having a two subsidiary cells which are arranged in a different manner. On the top of, on the head of gardasil, one cell is arranged, and at the bottom there is one cell, that is a dicytic. A parasitic means nothing but a guard cell which are showing subsidiary cell are arranged in a parallel fashion. And last one, that is the gramineous. Gramineous means a stomata type, means a dumbbell type of the stomata which is found in all monocotyledonous plant, that we will discuss in this unit 3. Then you come to the unit 4, that is the palynology. In the second year we have studied the taxonomy in a relation to the palynology. A palynology is nothing but a study of a pollen grains. So in that small unit we have to collect the different pollen grains around our college campus. We have the number of plant diversity in around our college campus, so it is very easy. So we have to study here the intine and exine, then how we can collect it, where it is stored, in which chemical content we have to store, and what is the viability of particular pollen grains. The viability of every plant individual, the viability of pollen grain of every species is a different one. So that we are going to study here. Then germination and the growth of pollen grain. Then germination, again one phenomena. The pollen grain naturally germinated, and we can do also artificially. In our lab we can germinate it. So there is a two method, artificial also, and in a plant there is a natural germination onto the stigma, and how it is behaving with this stigma, how pollen grain started to form the small tube like structure to long elongated tube, and so that structure we are will study in this subunit. Then application of palynology in honey industries, then coal, oil exploration, and aerobiology, and pollen allergies, and forensic science. So this application is also very much important. I will told you one good story. The even in our forensic science, in criminal forensic science, the palynology plays a very much important role. So that's why the Mumbai University is included this topic to in your syllabus. So after completing of your BSc, you can join a forensic lab, or you can do the MSc in forensic science, and you will get the job. Even into the honey industry also you can apply. The honey industry is also having a good recruitment, because the honey industry is always investigating about the good honeys, and the people are like monofloral or multifloral honeys. So that can be investigated after the studying the pollen morphology. If our honey having a different type of the pollen grain, so that will be a multifloral. And if the honey is having a single type of the pollen grain into the honey, so that will be the monofloral. Even into the oil exploration, then aerobiology, even our common air is having a different pollen grains, so that should be how it is collected. There is one professor from our Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University, Tilak sir, who has invented a very good instrument for the aerobiology, that we will discuss in this topic. Then again, it is a common behavior of people when they are come in contact with the plants or grasses, or in some plants, flowers, they get allergies. Why that is happen, that we will going to study in this pollen allergies. And last one, that is the forensic science, how pollen morphology is useful to find out the criminals. how it is enrolled into the forensic science, that we will study in this last unit, that is named as a palynology. We have basic four unit, and every unit having about 15 lectures. Okay, so here I will stop. In the next lecture we will start with our unit number second, that is nothing but angiosperm. Unit number second we will start into the next lecture. Thank you.